Good morning everyone. Today I am discussing about the validation of autoclave. What do you mean validation and what is the validation of autoclave? So first of all, in my previous video I already told that the definition, working function, construction of autoclave, their applications and uses also. Today I am discussing about the validation and validation of autoclave. So let's go. First of all, what do you mean validation? Validation may be defined as it is one type of establishing documented evidence and which provides a high degree of assurance that a specific process will consistently produce a product and meeting its predetermined specifications and quality attributes. That means validation is a one type of establishing documented evidence and which provides a high degree of assurance the process of any type of equipments. Okay, so validation of steam sterilization or validation of moisture sterilization. So autoclave is also included into the moisture sterilization or steam sterilization. So describe the sterilization techniques that utilize hot air, that is a heavily loaded facilitated efficient sterilization by steam and pressure. Mainly autoclave contains the pressure and steam. Okay, so in this case the steam acts as a main function under the pressure. So first of all, the validation of the autoclave, first point is a qualification and calibration. Qualification means the machine is how much qualified quality, and calibration means the how will you calibrate the machine, that means the error free machine. So there are 3 points are included into the qualification and calibration. Mechanically checking, upgrading, qualifying the sterilizing units. First point. Second point, selection and calibration of thermocouples. And third one, container mapping. So first point, qualification and calibration. Qualification and calibration means the complete removal of air from chamber and replacement with the saturated steam. And older autoclave really relied on gravity displacement. Another point, modern autoclave use cycles of vacuum and steam processes to increase the efficiency of air removal. And then temperature and pressure instruments must be calibrated. Qualification and calibration means first of all complete removal of air from chamber. First of all you have to remove the air from the chamber of autoclave and replacement with the saturated steam. And next, older autoclave relied on gravity displacement. But in this case, but nowadays the modern autoclave is used in our industry, pharmaceutical industry, and in this case this type of modern autoclave use cycles of vacuum and steam pulses to increase the efficiency of air removal. That means the modern autoclave helps to increase the efficiency of air removal. Okay, and another point is very important, that is temperature and pressure instruments must be calibrated. This pressure and temperature is very important part of the autoclave and they should be calibrated. Okay, and next point, the selection and calibration of thermocouple. Thermocouple means which produce the heat. So first of all, copper constant wires coated with Teflons are popular choice. So in this case, which type of wire you will choose? The copper constant, copper and Teflons, these are popular. And next, accuracy of thermocouple should be plus minus 0.5 degree centigrade. And in this case the 0.1 degree centigrade in temperature by faulty thermocouple will produce 2.3% error in calculation. So temperature should be mentioned in this case. So temperature is very important for the thermocouples, and you have to choose the accurate thermocouple's temperature. And thermocouple accuracy is determined using the temperature calibration instruments. So first of all, you have to calibrate the calibration. You have to calibrate the instruments or equipments which is used to determine the accurate temperature of the thermocouple. Thermocouple should be calibrated before and after validation experiment, two temperatures, 0 degree centigrade and 125 degree centigrade. And temperature sensed more than 0.5 degree centigrade by thermocouples should be discarded. So these points you should be followed for the validation of autoclave. And another point is container mapping. Container mapping, it is also included into the qualification and calibration part. So what is the container mapping? A sufficient number of thermocouples should be positioned in areas representing upper, lower and middle portions of the container. That means the sufficient number of thermocouples should be positioned, means you have to select the sufficient number of thermocouples into the upper layer, upper area or lower area into and middle area of autoclaves. And also this type of thermocouples are placed into the container. Okay. So next point, error in cold spot determination may be introduced by employing excessive number of thermocouples. Error in cold spot determination may be introduced by employing excessive number of thermocouples. If you will choose or if you will select or if you will place the maximum thermocouples or excessive thermocouples for the container, then you can follow, there is a many type of errors are produced. Okay, for in the cold spot. Another point is repeat studies are required to establish cold point and temperature profiles. That means now you have to study them repeatedly to establish the cold point and temperature profiles. Okay, that means when you will determine when you will calculate the cold point and temperature, that time you have to repeatedly follow the studies. So this is very required or this is very necessary for the container mapping validation. Another point is the temperature profile of container should remain constant among different sterilizing chamber in which sterilizing medium is steam heat. So temperature profile of container should remain constant among different sterilizing chamber in which sterilizing medium is steam heat. This is also very important. So next, second point, heat distribution studies. Heat distribution means the already you know the steam and pressure are very important, and main part steam and pressure is important for the autoclave. So now heat distribution of studies, what is the validation of heat distribution? There are two phases, first of all in empty autoclave chamber and in loaded autoclave chamber. Okay. So 10 to 20 thermocouples are placed into defined position and where should not make contact with the autoclave walls or any metal surface. So first of all you have to follow or you have to check the where should not make contact with autoclave walls or any metal surface. Okay, and in this case the main important notes is that the mean temperature difference between cool spot and chamber difference should not be greater than plus minus 2.5 degree centigrade, and you have to follow this difference plus minus 2.5 degree centigrade. This temperature you have to check out when you will maintain the validation of the heat distribution studies. Okay, and another part is the thermocouples should remain in ice bath and ice temperature all bath during each cycle. And the key is the identify cool spot, the effect of load size and configuration on cool spot location. Okay. And another last point is a heat penetration study. This is also very important. Heat penetration study, it is important because the total when you will sterilize the any type of products into the autoclave, then the steam, that means the heat, is easily penetrated to the materials and easily destroy the spore of microorganism, and that's why moist heat sterilization or autoclave is very important or very effective than the dry heat sterilization. So what will you do, it is most critical component in which the containers cold spot for containers greater than 1000 ml is determined using container mapping studies. That means that it is also related to the container mapping studies. The thermocouple are inserted into the container and outside the container to establish the cold point and the constant temperature bus. That means when the when you will place the thermocouple into the container part, that time the outside part is called the cold point, okay, the cold spot. Minimum and maximum loading configuration should be studied, okay, and the effect of load variation on time and temperature profile must also be determined. And last point is the goals. The goals are to ensure that the validation cycle will remain unchanged in future, and any change in load size, load configuration or container characteristics must accompanied by repeat validation studies to prove that the cool spot location has not changed. So this is a very important part of the heat penetration studies, and already I am discussing about the autoclave validation. What do you mean validation? What is, how will you validate the autoclave? So these points are very important for the moist heat sterilization and autoclave also.